Hi, I'm Tsenka Tsanova, and I'm going to speak today on the recent research on the Middle to Upper Paleolithic transitional period in northern Bulgaria and the earliest evidence of modern Homo sapiens from Bacho Kiro Cave. There are two competing theories on the origin of modern humans, the out of Africa and the multi-regional hypothesis. Both agree that Homo erectus originated in Africa and expanded to Eurasia about 1.8 million years ago. But they differ, the theories, in explaining the origin of modern human. The first theory proposes that the second migration out of Africa happened about 100,000 years ago, in which an anatomically modern human of African origin conquered the world by completely replacing archaic human population. The multi-regional hypothesis states that independent multiple origin or shared multi-regional evolution with continuous gene flow between continental populations occurred in the million years since Homo erectus came out of Africa. A combined version of out-of-Africa hypothesis emphasizes the African origin of most human populations but allow for the possibility of minor local contributions, like was the case between modern human and Neanderthal. On this map in blue, in the single wave dispersal model, and in red the multi-regional waves, In green are the migration back to Africa. We have now not only archaeological evidence about those migrations, but also Paleolithic proofs on the interactions between different human types. In 2009, the DNA team from our institute, led by Svante Pebo, had completed the first draft of the Neanderthal genome. Since then, paleogenetic studies have increased. Thanks to paleogenetics, we know today that Neanderthal reached as far as Siberia and lived and interbred with extinct human types, the Denisovian man. Also, Neanderthal and modern human interacted in the Levant before 50,000 years ago. All early Homo sapiens recovered from Europe have 5 to 6 generations back in their family trees a Neanderthal ancestor. And there is much more that we don't know. Why we did prevail over the other humans 50,000 years ago, reach and settle most of the world, which genes we inherited from the archaic humans, and how this influenced our actual evolution. Here on this slide, I add the recovered numbers of early Upper Paleolithic Homo sapiens from Bacho Kiro Cave, four of them 45,000 years old, and two are dated of around 36 and linked to the urination period. The Southeastern Europe and the Balkan Peninsula is a key region for studying the movement of human populations and cultures into Europe. Known as the Gate of Europe and crossroad between Asia, Europe and indirectly with Africa, Neanderthal and Homo sapiens lived and passed through this region and either along the Danube corridor or the Adriatic coast. The cave Bacho Kiro is located in the central North Bulgaria on the north slope of the Balkan mountain near the town of Drianovo, 60 kilometers from the Danube River in the north and 200 kilometers from the Black Sea to the east. In the Google picture, the valley of Bacho Kiro Cave, the Drianovo Monastery and the town of Drianovo with view to the north toward the Danube Valley. Темната на Козарника caves are the other two sites with record from the beginning of the Upper Paleolithic time witnessing for early modern human presence in the area. The first results from Bacho Kiro Cave excavation came last year, 2020, in two Nature papers. The first paper report the directly dated human remains, and I linked to the initial Upper Paleolithic assemblage, bone, and also bone assemblage. And the sister paper present the chronology of the initial Upper Paleolithic occupation and represent the best dated site from this period. The cave is embedded in the canyon of the Andaka and Drianovo rivers in the Cretaceous limestone formations. To the right is a drone model of the cave area with the red point showing the location of the entry. The previous name of Bacho Kiro Cave is Malkata Peshtera, the small cave. And it is the first cave in Bulgaria adapted for visitors in the 38th of the last century. In this year, Rafael Popov, a pioneer Bulgarian archaeologist, and Dorothy Garrod first excavated the cave most extensively. Garrod was on her way back from Palestina and she was looking for the origin of the urination in Europe. Here on the Garrod picture, you see the cave full of sediments. Then in the 70s, after a larger excavation of a Polish-Bulgarian team led by Professor Kozlovsky and Ginter, the flow on the entry was rearranged and concreted together with the 50 square meters empty space left over from the excavation. The cave is a part of a four-level labyrinth karst system extending more than 3 kilometers, as you can see on the cave. Dorothy Garrod faced some difficulty with attribution of the stone collection from Bacho Kiro Cave. She even contacted Abbé Broy, a French priest archaeologist, and sent to him some diagnostic artifacts from Bacho Kiro for helping her with the cultural attribution of the collections. After the excavation in the 70s, the assemblage from the lower Upper Paleolithic layers 11 was proposed to be a pre-urination unit reflecting an early migration of Homo sapiens into Europe. In 2000, the collection was re-examined three times and the link to the urination was disputed. Then in my PhD, the lithic assemblage from layer 11, known also as the Bacho Kirian, was linked to the transitional middle to upper Paleolithic assemblages with Levallois elements and upper Paleolithic tool types. Since the last excavation in 2015, we classified the assemblage as a variant of the initial upper Paleolithic technocomplex of Eurasia, which technocomplex is defined in 2014. And here a quick reminder of the technocomplexes from the transitional MPUP period. On the bottom, the locally evolved bifacial leaf point assemblages linked to Neanderthal. Then the IUP assemblages combining blade production and Levallois technological elements. And first appearance in Europe of personal ornaments and bone industry, and the proto-urination and early urination, which are featuring bladelet production and art and musical instruments. And this is the most recent techno-complex. And we go back to Bacho Kiro Cave, the two areas of excavation, the main sector located in the periphery of the old excavations, and the niche one, where we find better preserved layer of the lower part of the sequence. Our grid system is adjusted to the previous one. The new numbering of the layers is with letter. We found all layers previously described from the excavation of the 70s. And you see on the plan the position of Kozlovsky and Garot excavation. In total, we explored by our excavation 13 square meters. The actual excavation and recording method, we use modern standard of excavation and recovery along with the suite of state-of-art analytical procedures. You can find our excavation methods in the internet, oldstoneage.com. And soon our database will be available online. Here a part of the initially uncovered profile in the main sector. This area appeared very poor in finds because it's close to the cave wall. Here the flow raised with 1 meter compared to the niche one. In the main sector, the middle Paleolithic and in the lower part of the IUP layers are not accumulated. The layers are composed mainly of clay, sand and silt in various proportions. All sediments are of endokarstic origin. The boundaries between the layers are gradual, except for the layer I, where we have a shift of sedimentation mode. As you can see on the picture, layer I is composed by a darker sediment rich in coal. And a 3D model of the main sector with the plotted finds per layer. It's what we do. The profile drawings and picture from both areas. So the upper part of the sequence is better preserved in the main sector and the lower part of the sequence is better preserved in the sector niche 1. You can see on the picture below the sediments of layer I, the initial upper Paleolithic with concentration of charcoals and another anthropogenetic inputs. Is really hard contrast between the layer I, the palimpsest, compared to the other layers. The upper layers in the niche do not correlate with the main sector and they are sterile or poor of archaeological material. All layers from the niche are prefixed with N1 for niche 1. The lower layers G, I and J upper part correlate with the main sector and this is confirmed also by micromorphology of the sediments, the C14 dates and human DNA refits one tooth, which is the tooth which is found in the main sector, refit with the human fragments from the niche 1 sector. They belong to one individual. Plot of the bones and lytic per layers. The lytic assemblage from layer J is technotypologically consistent with the IUP from layer I. The density of finds show that occupation began on the top of the Mousterian layer K and intensify from the upper part of layer J. The density of finds is linked to the intensive activities. The finds in the overlying layer H and the contact zone layer H and I are also consistent with the IUP and belong to one technological tradition. And here a comparison of the archaeological control features between the previous and the new excavation. You can see that we find similar features but in different proportions. So on the old excavation, they were more clear fireplaces with high concentration of finds. Our excavation in the periphery is with not clear shapes of hearths, but deposit composed of a jumbo of charcoals and other anthropogenetic inputs. Also a very high percentage of a white patina, a lot of most of the lithic. We found higher proportion of burnt lithic compared to the old excavation. And we precise the dates, and we see the dates are, in fact, radiocarbon dates are with older, 3,000 years older than the previous one. The formation and micromorphology studies clearly demonstrate the anthropogenetic accumulation of layer I, the reduced thickness of the layer, high density of finds, evidences of tramping, in situ broken bones, suggest that people live on the top of the debris from previous occupation and in creating a palimpsest of indistinguishable occupation levels with a slow sedimentation rate. Moreover, low quantity of carnivore modification and high number of cut marks and debris from bone working confirm that the palimpsest is not disturbed. The cave bear bones were introduced and used by the humans. The lithic assemblages from the upper and the lower layers are comparable with the assemblage in layer I. We are not able for the moment to distinguish occupation phases. Here a model of the excavation from last excavation season 2019. You see the bedrock where we excavated the middle Paleolithic layers and the IUP dark layers, which are going to be excavated hopefully soon. From this context, we sampled systematically about 220 DNA sediment samples and found very interesting remains. Middle Paleolithic Neanderthal came first in the cave where it was empty of sediments. And between Mousterian and IUP, there are 3,000 years of chronology. And now I will present the human remains and the results, and then the archaeological assemblages and the chronology. So in the main sector was found the first identifiable human remain, a tooth in the upper part of layer J. Then all other human remains were identified by zoo mass spectrometry or reading the molecular barcode, which is unique for each species. Four human bones are from layer I in the niche, and they are linked genetically to the tooth in the main sector. So all the IUP human remains are from main. The map show the distribution of the main IUP sites of Western and Central Eurasia and the directly dated human remains from this period. The plotted dates below show that the early Homo sapiens from Bacho Kiro is contemporaneous to human from Ust-Tishim in Siberia. Neanderthals from Western Europe are with younger dates. The Oase skeleton is younger with at least 5 millennia. And to the right, the mitochondrial DNA analyze demonstrate that the humans found in Bacho Kiro fall on the base of four different haplogroups. This means that those people originate most probably from different locations. The specimens from the urination period found in the upper layer are genetically unrelated to the IUP humans from Bacho Kiro Cave. The haplotypes of the IUP people are extinct today in Europe, but present in the American Native people and other spot of Eastern Asia, and one spot of Eastern Asia. The condition in the cave, permanent temperature of 13 degrees Celsius, enabled the excellent preservation of the bone collagen and the DNA preserved in the sediment, together with the various animal DNA preserved in the sediment. We have also a human DNA. The nuclear DNA results will be soon published, and we have. Now we will look close to the initial Upper Paleolithic assemblage produced by the earliest Homo sapiens in Europe. Why we consider it before having the DNA analyze of the human remains that the IUP assemblage is locally intrusive and represent a new cultural entity. First archaeological evidence was the shift of raw material between the Mousterian and the IUP. Neanderthals were using mostly metamorphic, coarse-grained rock, while the IUP lithics are in fine-grained flint from five different locations that you see on the map. Aptian and Campanian flint are finished products were imported from a distance between 80 to 150 kilometers from the cave, a typical modern human behavior. We used the phonemic approach for address stratigraphic issue by refits and special distribution analysis. The analyze of the lithic is based on a classic Chen operatoire approach, which is widely published, and then we register the collected data in an entry program E4, which is available online. And here the technotypological counts of the assemblage. Most of the assemblage is composed by flakes, 33%. Nevertheless, retouched and small flakes from retouch, from shaping the retouch, is together 37% and suggest that tools are made in the cave. The largest blades were produced off-site. And the retouched tools, characterized by Upper Paleolithic and Middle Paleolithic types. From our record, most frequent are retouched and pointed blades, and equally higher frequency of the retouched flakes. The retouch is various, generally continuous, direct and semi-abrupt, from long invasive to covering. The diagnostic stone tools are pointed blades, with some of them fitting to the typological description of Mousterian points. Lateral side scrapers, combination of various shapes, slight oblique truncation, asymmetric apex, etc. Use were analyzed showed that pointed blades were multifunctional, but from the other side we have diagnostic impact fracture, which demonstrate that probably they have been used as a head of thrusting or throwing spears. The blade production is continuous from a big to small blades. Large blades are with straight profiles and many resulting from bipolar reduction. Also more elegant blades like this one on the right. Some small laminar products and bladelets resulting from anvil percussion. The knapping technique is direct percussion by hard hammer, with few examples of soft hammer. The most prominent economical aspect of the assemblage is high fragmentation and extensive reduction, followed by the majority of the tools and blank. Here on the left, the schema show various reduction stages and reshaping of the blade fragments, which were transformed in triangular scrapers used as wedges or as cores, also reduced on a narrow edge as the burins. And the use were analyzed, demonstrate pointed and other blades were used intensively for working on various materials, hide, wood and bones. We discovered a great number of anthropogenetically modified objects. Work pieces include oars, lissoirs and incised pieces. Several of the artifacts have a red staining that is consistent with the use of ochre. We identified one perforated ivory bead and 12 perforated or groved pendants, 11 of which were made from cave bear teeth and one from an ungulate tooth. And here we can follow a comparison with personal ornaments found in the IUP sites from Siberia, and we have also one bead in sandstone. The fauna remains are very well preserved, almost 20% for layer I and more than 30% in layer J of the fauna is identifiable. Predominant species are large and medium sizes herbivores and also cave bear, which was butchered at the site. The most represented species are both bison, cervid, equid, also capra. From the carnivores, the Ursus speleus predominates, and it could have been hunted inside the cave. Some of the species are adapted to a very cold climate. Archaeological analyze suggests that herbivore carcasses were transported to the site relatively complete and butchered on-site. At least 32 individuals are recognized. Full butchery sequence is identified across herbivore and carnivore species. Almost 13% of the bones present human modification as cut marks. And some result, preliminary result from Anthropology is an ongoing study. So we have detected evergreen tree from the olive family, birch, pine. One of the new investigation lastly developed in France and Spain is mapping the traces of the cave walls and looking for Paleolithic art or other marks. So far, nothing promising in Bacho Kiro Cave for art, but we could register the traces from the cave bear's claw inside the cave, some pigments, etc., and the trenches of Dorothy Garrett excavation and treasure hunter holes, as you can follow on this map. Surely the Homo sapiens exploited inside the cave. And there are some evidence from Dorothy Garrett excavation which need future investigations. For Bacho Kiro Cave, we produce a very robust chronology with more than 90 IMS high precision dates and bone. The old radiocarbon dates from Temnata Kozarnica are with large error range, usually above 1000 years and more. Nevertheless, it enables rough comparison of the chronologies. Here on the Bayesian model, we see that IUP occupation started at 48,000 BP, and in layer I, the dates conform with the stratigraphy are between 45 and 43,000 years ago, including the human remains in purple. Our colleague Helen Fewers helped with recalibrating the previous radiocarbon dates, which fall in the period of middle upper Paleolithic transition and the time of the replacement of Neanderthal by the modern human. The closest dates at circa 48,000 are from Tuplica cave, excavated in 2011, and Kozarnica at the base of the upper Paleolithic sequence, layer 6-7. One more record matching here is from the open-air site of Museljevo. The largest foliate leaf point assemblage is estimated to between 50 to 45,000 years BP and is very likely was the work of Neanderthal, the Museljevo assemblage. It is interesting to see that the old calibrated dates from Temnata layer 4, the IOP tradition like in Bacho Kiro, and Kozarnica layer 5C, the earliest local bladelet technology, present very close chronologies. Those two distinct technological traditions, blade and bladelets productions, are probably coexisting. Other chronological marker is the in the transitional MPUP sequence is the companion ignimbrite I5 tephra. The tephra accumulated in the layers when is in primary position and undisturbed allowed to follow the chronology of the assemblages before and after 39,000 years BP, the time of the volcanic super eruption in South Italy. In Temnata, Sector 2, the assemblage from Layer 6 containing IUP blades and Levallois technology is covered by this CI tephra and is older than 39,000 BP. In Sector 1, the CI tephra is located directly above the Mousterian layers and below the layer 4, which is a IUP tradition, like in Bacho Kiro. In Kozarnica cave, the CI tephra is located within the layer 5C, or the earliest bladeless assemblage called early Kozarnikin. In Bacho Kiro, there is no tephra, but the IUP here is surely the earliest blade tradition and coincide very likely with the record from Samuilica, Kozarnica level 6-7 and Tuplica caves. Here the succession of currently recognized technocomplexes at the middle to upper Paleolithic transition in Western Eurasia. The things are much more complex that you can see on this simplified table. In the Levant, we have the richest archaeological record from this time, the transition middle to upper Paleolithic. The record from the Balkans are much comparable to Levant down to Western Europe. Initially, Homo sapiens settled in the Balkans with IUP blade technologies, surely 45,000 years ago, coexisted in Europe with the last Neanderthals who died out 40,000 years ago, according the last papers. In this time, at 43,000 BP, appeared the earliest bladelet technocomplex in the Balkans, the early Kozarniken, and in the Western and Central Europe is the proto-urination. This technocomplex is the reflect of a second wave Homo sapiens, now also proven by the DNA analysis. And I finished the journey with the map from our last project publication. The black squares are all IUP sites in Eurasia, and the colored circles are the human remains genetically analyzed. The Homo sapiens of Bacho Kiro withdrew to Asia and melt into other groups. A second wave of Homo sapiens, unconnected with the previous one, gave rise of the Upper Paleolithic in Europe, the urination and the gravation. We have also genetic evidences of the interaction between Neanderthals and modern human, as it was found in Siberia, a hybrid of Denisovian Neanderthal. We know that there were several human types in this time interacting with each other. Many questions remain unanswered about the local adaptation of the Homo sapiens group and the inter-site connectivity. We try to relate one archaeological unit to another, close in time and concept of culture and technology, building a regional record. One of the main quests is to relate the records to the events, to reconstruct the paleoenvironment and understand the technology and culture as an adaptation response to the environment. We see that each region followed different development and that the records are related somehow. Researchers have long been aware of the broad distribution of certain more or less well-defined cultural phenomena. Earlier culture complexes such as the proto and early urination, the gravation, are also very well widespread within Eurasia. Like the initial Upper Paleolithic, those conjuncture of features existed over a large geographic scales, and they are probably the consequence of multiple processes, including migration, cultural transmission, and technological convergence. And I thank to all my colleagues working in the Bacho Kiro project, here the ongoing interdisciplinary research that I hope we will finish, and I hope we can return soon to excavation and study sessions. Thank you for your attention.